Disclaimer, this is not authentic pasta carbonara. This is Americanized pasta carbonara. In real pasta carbonara, you do not use heavy whipping cream or bacon. Okay.
No bacon?
Yeah, you don't use bacon. So, yeah, this is Americanized pasta carbonara. So don't be coming at me in the comments of this video that this is fake, because full disclaimer, okay. Hi, welcome to Focus Kitchen. I'm Jonathan, and I'm the head chef of this ordeal tonight. We won't be needing this tonight because we're making pasta carbonara.
Paul, what do you think?
This is gonna be real good.
Yes, it is.
I think it is going to be great.
Listen up, because this is what you're gonna need to feed 6 people. You're gonna need 12 ounces of pasta, any variety. You're gonna need 8 pieces of thick cut bacon, dice it up small. You're gonna need 2 cloves of garlic, mince it up. You're gonna need half of a whole onion, of a medium-sized onion. You're gonna need 3 eggs, 3 of these guys. You're gonna need 3/4 cups of finely grated parmesan, 3/4 cup of heavy cream, salt, and plenty of pepper. And don't forget half a cup of peas.
Yay!
Wait, do you need me to save any bacon?
Yeah, do you want to chop the onion?
Ooh, garlic.
Mixing some garlic.
Nice.
So we're going to want to have some bacon, and we're going to chop it up. We're going to cube it like this. Elizabeth is doing a great job.
Chef Cass. I was thinking over your ears.
She's not on our team. Helping us out, and she's chopping up some onions.
He's not on Team Glimmy either.
No.
But he's not helping either.
I will be helping.
That's gonna be awesome in the video.
I'm Trish. I'm not on Team Columbia either, and I am camera woman. This is water.
I'm going to be frying the bacon.
Any updates?
No.
Just B-roll then.
Okay, so once the bacon is done frying, you're going to want to take it out of the pan and put it in a bowl, but save the bacon grease. And we're going to add a little bit of the bacon grease to the pan, and we're going to use that to fry the onions. Okay, we're going for a caramelization here. The background music is Shania Twain.
So we will butter bread, garlic powder, salt, broiler, garlic bread.
Oh, this won't be too much.
Yum.
TW, do you want me to add this to your bacon grease collection?
Sure.
Wow.
Sprinkle some salt on there.
Okay, so now we're going to add the eggs in a bowl, and we're going to mix the parmesan now in the bowl. So now what you're gonna wanna do is you wanna get a whisk, and you're gonna wanna whisk it.
We don't have a whisk.
You can use a fork if you don't have a whisk.
It's probably the closest thing. Do you want this?
I've been able to be in the pan frying for a little bit. Then you're going to want to take the garlic and throw the garlic in the pan. And then stir it up and saute it a bit.
Hey guys, here's a quick side dish that we made to go with the pasta and bread. It's a tomato cucumber salad. It just has tomatoes and cucumbers and olive oil and balsamic vinegar and salt and pepper. And that's it. So yeah, you can just chop them up and mix it all in there. You can figure out the proportions. You kind of just eyeball it, but it's a good side dish.
Okay, so when the pot is boiling, you're gonna wanna put the pasta in so it can cook probably for about 8 minutes to get all dente.
Also make this dish gluten-free. Oh no, pasta.
We're human here.
When it's whisked, it should look like something like this. Okay, so now we're going to add the heavy whipping cream. I know the recipe says 3/4, but if you're trying to make healthy choices, you can use 1/2 cup. Of course, I'm kidding on that last part. We live in a free country. Okay, so once the heavy whipping cream is whisked in, we're gonna add pepper, and we're gonna add salt, and then stir that in. This pasta is about done, and we're gonna strain it. But first, you're gonna wanna take out some of the pasta water and save it and set it aside. Maybe, I don't know, 1/2 bowl so of hot water or so. Go time. We're about to strain this pasta, and as soon as we strain this pasta, we're gonna wanna put it back in the pot, and we're gonna wanna pour the egg parmesan mixture in, and we're gonna stir it. It's very important to do this as fast as you can so the heat of the pasta and the heat of the pot will cook the eggs, right? Very important, because you don't wanna eat uncooked eggs. You'll get sick, okay? And if you're just very scrupulous about it, maybe heat it up a little bit, right? But yeah. Okay.
So much pasta.
Wanna put that back in the pot here. All right, cool. So someone grab the mixture. So we're gonna pour this in, and you need to be stirring in this mixture with the sauce. You need to be stirring in the mixture with the pasta. Okay, so then that way it can cook, right? So the heat releases while you're stirring the pot. Ha 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 ha. Stirring the pot. Yeah. Cool. So once you're stirring this for about maybe, so you're gonna know it's cooked when you start seeing the egg, right? You're gonna start seeing the egg cook, and it's gonna start sticking to the noodles. You're gonna start seeing bits of cooked egg on there, right? And that's how you know to stop stirring. Stir that in. That's probably enough, huh?
Gluten-free version.
Yeah. Right, it might seem a little wet right now, but you keep stirring it up, it'll start thickening. All right, so now we're gonna add the onions and garlic mixture into the pastas while we're stirring it in, and we're gonna add the bacon in as well.
What? That's more bacon than I can stir.
Yeah, we definitely put a little more bacon than the recipe calls for, but, you know, God bless. Yeah.
My heart.
Oh, there's so much bacon up
there. If you're having long pasta, like spaghetti or something like that, as you're stirring, it's going to get really dry. That's what the saved pasta water is for. You add it in, and it'll help them loosen up everything. Now, if you're going to have something like short pasta, kind of like penne or mussatoli, it might not thicken right away. And if that's the case, you might want to put it back on the stove with the sauce in the pot and the pasta, and start stirring it while it's on the stove with this temperature on the stove. Now all the food is set, but wait a sec. Hats off, because it's time to pray. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Bless us, O Lord,
and these thy gifts which we are about to receive from thy bounty through Christ our Lord, amen.
In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. And don't forget to pray for the holy souls after you eat.